So now let's start with the chapter number 1, Basics of Information Technology. Now in this chapter, what things we are going to learn? So here the definition of information technology as well as ICT. To understand the concepts like data and information, the various concepts used under IT, different types of operating systems with its features and uses, the operating systems which are working on the desktop computers as well as on the mobiles, then architecture of computer system, units of memory, the concepts related to internet and network with its types, and recent trends in IT as well as IT enabled services. Now let's begin with the definition of information technology. Now what do you mean by information technology? So it includes the main 5 processes. Now which are the 5 processes in that one? The first one is the collect, create, process, protect, and store. So these 5 words are very important. So it is nothing but a technology which encompasses of all the technologies that we use in order to do the following processes. Now, as you know, in the computer, the information is transferred from one PC to another PC, or from one file is transferred to the another file. Now here, the create means the creation of new type of information. A new information is created. For example, when you type a letter and when you save it, then a new letter is created with certain contents. So this is called as creation of information. Collection means we have to collect certain amount of data. For example, now there are many students in class. So class teacher has to collect all the information about the student, like the roll number of the student, name of the student, date of birth of the student, then category or caste of the student, register number of the student. So whenever he or she collects the information about the student, then it forms a student's complete database. Computer, as you know, always processes the information. So here, when you enter something inside the PC, then it processes on it and gives us the accurate result in the form of output. It protects the information. Protect means unauthorized access is there, that is without our knowledge. When the person is gaining the information from us, then that is called as unauthorized access. To prevent your particular data from these types of unauthorized access, so we need to protect the computer as well as protect the data. So by giving the password or by installing the antivirus software, you can protect the data. And obviously last one is storing of the information. So whenever you create any type of new information, then for our use, we have to store it in the computer. So information technology is nothing but a process that we use in order to create a new data, collection of data, processing of data, protection of data, and storing of information. What is another definition? So another definition is, it refers to the hardware, software, and the computer networks. Now, what do you mean by hardware? Hardware is nothing but the parts, the physical parts to which we can touch. Software is nothing but the computer programs, or which we called as the set of instructions. And computer network. Computer network means a network of networks. That is, many computers, they are connected together to transfer the information. So information technology is nothing but it is a collection of hardware, software, as well as the computer networks. Now next concept is ICT. So ICT stands for information and communication technology. This concept involves the transfer. The main word is the transfer and use of all kinds of information. So transfer and use. Transfer means transfer of information from one PC to another PC. And use, the use of that information. So ICT, information and communication technology, involves the transfer as well as the use of all the kinds of information. For example, now there are different examples for ICT. sitting at home, if you have the PC and the internet connected to PC, then we can do n number of operations. Like we can work from home, that you learned in the COVID situation. Online classes were going on, still they are also going on. Distance learning, sitting here you can opt for the any abroad university course. E-banking facility, sitting at home you can transfer money or you can make the online FDs also. E-governance, certain government certificates if you require, then sitting at home also you can get that certificates. They are now possible from any place with an internet connection and a computing device. So if you have internet as well as a computing device at your home, then you can do all the types of processes. Now data and information. Now if you see this figure, so here you can see the data. There is a processing is done on the data and which forms information. So in short, the data is nothing but the raw material, facts and figures. It is unprocessed information because processing is not done on the particular information. Now for example, data is of various types. Data may be from the numbers 0 to 9, alpha, it's A to Z, special characters like greater than sign, less than sign, percentage sign, dollar sign, hash sign. So different special characters which we use, they are also known as the raw material or the unprocessed information. Now here example is UMBAR 1234XYZ, which is a raw material. There is nothing done, processing done on this data. That's why it is known as unprocessed information. Data is nothing but unprocessed information. Now what do you mean by information? So information is nothing but the processed data when the processing is done on the data. Now for example, take the example of addition of two numbers. Now if you ask computer add 3 and 5, it will not understand, because whatever things we have to feed in the computer, it must be in the form of proper program. So here two variables, suppose we use A and B. Now A, in the A first number we store and in the B second number we store. So we will give the computer instructions that enter the first value in the form of A and enter the second value in the form of B. So when these numbers are entered, then finally our expression becomes C is equal to A plus B, where C is another variable which is used to store the result. So here when I write A plus B, so here plus stands for the addition. So here addition processing is done on the variables A as well as B, where the result is stored in the form of C. So by adding A and B, by doing the process of addition, whatever result is generated, that is nothing but your information. So C is your processed data and as it stores the result. So here also in the diagram, if you see, the data is processed to form the information. That's why information is called as processed data and data is called as unprocessed information. Now why there is a need of information? So information is required to take the short term as well as long term decisions, and also to take the strategic decisions in the organization. For example, if data is available with you and you don't know how to use that data. So if you have a team of your members, then everyone's opinion is different. So when all will discuss together and generate certain type of decision, so that is called as the information. So information is used to take the different types of decisions. That is the most important use of information. So data is unprocessed information and information is processed data. Now computer. As you know, a computer is a device which works on electricity. Without electricity, computer doesn't work. That you also know. So normal definition, if you say, so computer is nothing but an electronic device. It derived from a Latin word which is called as computare, which means to calculate, to count, to sum up or to think together. It is an electronic device which includes three different types of processes. One is called as input, second is called as process, and third is called as a output. So it includes three different processes as input, process and output. Input is the information which is entered by the user. So whenever user types from the keyboard, so that information is entered inside the computer, which is called as input. CPU is the main part which is used to process the information. So processing part is done with the help of CPU, that is central processing unit. And whatever result is generated, that is a meaningful result, which is called as the output. So it is an electronic device. Now, what is the definition of computer? So it is an electronic device which accepts the input data, processes on that data, and gives us the meaningful result in the form of output. A computer can process. Now we can enter different types of text, numbers, images, audio files, video files, as well as the graphics. Now what are the functions of computer? So you remember the word ASPGC. A stands for accept, S stands for store, P stands for process, G stands for gives results, and C stands for control. So computer accepts the data and instructions in the form of input. So whatever user feed, that is input. So it accepts that data from the user. Second thing, it stores the data. When we press Ctrl plus S command, then it stores the data. It processes on that data. Then whatever data is processed, then final result is generated. So that result is also given to us by the computer in the form of output. And it controls all the operations inside as well as outside the computer. So here, accept, stores, process, gives results and controls, these are the main functions of your computer. Now see, this is the architecture of computer, where a computer has different parts. We can see a monitor is there, CD drive are there, system unit is there, printer is there which is attached externally, hard disk drives are there, flash memory card reader is there, flash memory picture to capture the pictures this device is used, mouse is there, disks are there, keyboard is there, microphone is there, and the speakers are there to produce the audio. So these are the main parts of your computer which are attached either externally or they are sometimes inbuilt. So system unit is the CPU, main CPU is called as the system unit. Printer is used to produce the output. Hard drive is used to store the information. Then mouse is the pointing device to open the applications. Keyboard is used to give the instructions to the computer. Microphone is used to get the spoken input. Speakers produce output, and monitor, it is an output device which we can, whatever the user types, that we can able to see. Now here CD stands for compact disc and DVD stands for digital versatile disc. Now every computer system has the following basic components. Now as you know, there are three basic components of every computer system. First one is input unit, second one is central processing unit, that is CPU, and third one is output unit. Input unit helps the users to enter the data and commands into the computer system. Data can be in the form of numbers, words, actions, commands, etc. So whatever data a user feeds in the computer, that is called as the input. The main function of input device is to direct commands and data into the computer. So, for example, a keyboard, it is an input device that enters numbers and characters in the form of input. Now, CPU, it is known as the brain of the computer. So, after receiving data and commands from the users, a computer system has to process all the types of instructions. It is further divided. There are main parts of the CPU. One is memory unit, Second one is control unit, and third one is ALU, that is arithmetic and logical unit. The third basic component is output unit. The third and final component of computer system is called as the output unit, which gives us the meaningful results after processing the input instructions. So after processing the data, it is converted into a format which human can understand. After conversion, the output unit displays this data to users which human can read, that is human readable form. So devices which includes monitors, screen printers, speakers, they are known as the output devices, because whatever information is there, that directly we can able to see on the output devices. Now next is your memory unit. Memory unit or block diagram of computer, they are the same. So memory unit, again it includes, if you see the diagram, so here again it is shown by input unit, central processing unit and the output unit. Now input unit, as you know, it is used to enter the information inside the CPU. CPU is used to process the information and output unit is used to generate the result. So memory has the three different parts. Memory is mainly divided into two parts. One is primary memory and second one is secondary memory. Then control unit and the arithmetic and logical unit. Now once user enters the data using input devices, the computer system stores this data in its memory unit. This data will remain here until the components of CPU processes it. The memory unit uses a set of pre-programmed instructions to further transmit this data to other parts of the CPU. Now the types of memory. There are main two types. One is primary memory and second is secondary memory. Primary memory is internal memory of the computer, which is also called as the main memory of the computer. Primary memory holds the data and instructions on which computer is currently working. Primary memory is divided into two types. One is RAM, which is called as random access memory, and second one is ROM, that is read-only memory. RAM is called as a volatile memory or it is temporary memory. As soon as the computer switched off, whatever data is there, that data get lost. So it is called as the temporary memory. It is also known as read or write memory. Then ROM, that is read-only memory, it is called as the permanent memory, because whatever information is there, as the light switch off, still it remains on the CPU. So it is also known as non-volatile memory. The content of ROM is decided by the computer manufacturer and permanently stored at the time of manufacturing. ROM cannot be overwritten by the computer, and that's why it is called as non-volatile memory. So RAM is temporary or volatile and ROM is permanent and non-volatile memory. Secondary memory, the external memory of the computer, is called as secondary memory and it is used to store the huge amount of data and information. The secondary memory devices are magnetic disk, magnetic tape, pen drive, flash memory, optical disk in that CD, compact disk or digital versatile disk and SSD. On the cloud basis when you store, then it is in the form of SSD. Now very important units of memory. Like other units, memory has its own unit which is called as a byte. Bit is nothing but the binary digit which holds only one or one of two values at either 0 or 1. Nibble is a group of 4 bits. So 4 numbers together called as a nibble. And byte is a group of 8 bits. So a byte is the smallest unit which can represent a data atom or a character. Another units, the latest units if you want to see. So here 1 bit, 1 nibble is 4 bits, 1 byte is 8 bits. 1 kilobyte means 1024 bytes. 1 megabyte means 1024 kilobytes. 1 gigabyte is equal to 1024 megabytes. 1 terabyte is equal to 1024 gigabytes. 1 petabyte is equal to 1024 terabytes. 1 exabyte is equal to 1024 petabytes. 1 zettabyte is equal to 1024 exabytes. 1 yettabyte is equal to 1024 zettabytes. 1 brontobyte is equal to 1024 yettabytes. 1 gigabyte is equal to 1024 brontobytes. And 1 sagabyte is equal to 1024 gigabyte. So this is the sagabyte, is the latest unit of memory. Next one is your control unit. As control unit, in the name itself, it is given that it is used to control all the operations of input as well as output devices. It is also known as the backbone of computers, as it is responsible for coordinating the task between all the components of the computer. It collects the data from input unit and sends it to processing unit depending on its nature. Finally, it further transmits processed data to output unit to facilitate the users. And last one is your arithmetic and logical unit, which is used to do all the arithmetic as well as logical operations. Now, arithmetical operation includes the addition, subtraction, division and multiplication, and logical functions are AND, OR and NOT. So this is a separate unit which specially performs all the arithmetic and logical operations.